There are a combination of factors which you can attribute to the, you know, the rise in fraud in the card not present transactions. I would say predominantly three important factors. There is an expanding e-commerce transactions in the last few years. The second element is the growth in mobile commerce. And the third is the real-time payments. Now, I'll cover each one of them if you look at these three factors. One is the, you know, the rise in e-commerce transactions. The EMV chip-based transactions introduced for POS world, it has arrested many of the fraudulent transactions. Whereas the card-not-present transactions world or required an out-of-band authentication or an authentication which is very different from the traditional ways has increased the you know, fraudulent activities. The fraudsters managed to hack the e-commerce websites and managed to capture the cards, so which has resulted in an increase in the e-commerce frauds. The second important factor for us is the, you know, the increase in the mobile transactions. If you look at the number of mobile devices in the market, different form factors resulted in different types of frauds. Many of these apps and the devices pose almost close to 600% increase in the, you know, number of frauds which has happened over the previous year. So there are industry experts say that the ability to arrest the mobile based frauds will significantly reduce the, you know, the cost of transactions as well as the fraudulent activity. So that's the second factor for us. The third important factor is the real time payments. The real time payment industry has grown significantly in the last few years, and as many as 130 countries have adopted the real-time payments. If you look at an example of UK, faster payments was introduced in 2008, and due to lack of preparedness of the service providers, you could see a surge in the fraudulent activities almost by 130%. Fraudsters are looking for new ways to attack the real-time payments, so we need to be better prepared to handle the real-time payment world. If you look at the existing solutions, they create a rift between security or high level of security and simplification of the user experience. So we need to come out with an authentication methodologies which allow you to create a frictionless user experience. So if you look at the countries like India, where the two-factor authentication is prevalent, you see a 20% cart abandonment rate, which is significantly a loss to the merchants and the banks. So the industry is now moving towards a risk-aware authentication. The newer technologies like biometrics, AI, machine learning helps in terms of improving the authentication methodologies. So from a dual factor, people migrate towards a multi-factor authentication, so that which allows you to authenticate based on your customer behavior, based on your biometric identities, and improve the transaction flow without blocking the user experience and creating a friction between your transaction security as well as the simplification of the user experience. So at FSS, we have been building risk-based authentication related products for the last 18 months. And my colleague Kaushik Iyer will talk about what and how we have built the risk-based authentication tools, which will help improve the transaction speed and remove the friction.
We all know that the existing 3D Secure 1.0 protocol, where authentication is done either on static password or one-time password, has its own inherent defects or inherent shortcomings. The additional step at the time of checkout actually brings in a lot of cart abandonment from the end consumer. The impact actually is pronounced more in the mobile world, where at the time of checkout, the customer is actually redirected out of the app into the bank's website for 3DS authentication, which in most of the cases is not mobile compatible, and that leaves a very bad experience with the customer. FSS Secure 3D, secure, real-time, risk-based authentication solution based on 3DS 2.0 protocol addresses most of the shortcomings of 1.0. This renders 100% challenge rate obsolete. The solution actually leverages the data elements that are passed between the merchants and the issuers to actually detect fraud real time and then help the issuers take an informed decision on the authentication that has to be made. FSS Secure 3D also deploys sophisticated machine learning techniques to actually, you know, continuously learn from the fraud patterns that has happened over a period of time, which again the issuers can use for making informed decisions. The issuers can actually use various kinds of variables, which include variables related to cardholders, merchants, location, devices, and transactions to actually come up with a score, and then they can use the score to check whether the transaction was getting originated legitimately or not. Sure, FSS Secure 3D pinpoints a situation like implausible travel velocity, that is, customer can get logged on from two different locations, let's say from the US and from India, in a very short span of time, let's say 5 minutes. It catches situations like this, and it also catches situations when a same device gets used across multiple sites for shopping at the same time. Apart from these, there are situations around the billing address being different from the actual cardholder address. This gets caught when an online transaction happens, and also situations like transactions coming in from a rogue or a high alert country, along with very suspicious locale settings on the computer, like the hardware locale setting is different than the browser setting, and the physical IP belongs to a high risk country. All these situations, among others, are actually caught through our data models, and that is actually used for coming up with a risk score. Only when a risk score is really high, when the calculated risk score is high, we go to the next level of actually getting this transaction authenticated through a OTP or another authentication methods. Otherwise, if the score is pretty low, the transaction is allowed to pass through seamlessly. This way, what we actually achieve is you have a good customer experience, lower cart abandonment from the actual end customer, and also a better fraud prevention mechanism. All the three of them are achieved.
At the heart of FSS Secure 3D is our risk-based authentication engine. If you look at the risk-based authentication engine we have built with a powerful data model built over a period of time. We have been working on this for the last 18 months. And if you look at the FSS Secure 3D as a product, for every transaction, we profile more than 130 data elements. So which helps in terms of creating a frictionless experience as far as the transaction is concerned. So a lot of complex decision-making related to risk-based authentication happens basis these elements which collected over a period of time, not only from that particular transaction, but also collected based on the past historical behavior of these same customer. These transactions are collated and we arrive at a decision which helps in terms of improving the speed of transaction and gives a frictionless experience for the customers. At FSS, this solution is offered in FSSNet Private Cloud. We have chosen the private cloud option because the time to market for the financial institutions and the large issuers, and it also helps in terms of the complex decision making process involved in authenticating a transaction. If you look at FSS for the last 18 months, we have crossed over 300 million transactions and with an assured success rate of around 98% in terms of the authentication of the transactions. Now with the FSS Secure 3D 2.0 coming in, the number of data elements which are associated with these transactions increased to 130. So what it means is a very complex data model is built over a period of time, which allows quicker decision making for, or an improved decision making for, passing these transactions or declining these transactions for the consumers.